We are glad to introduce the Selenium IDE formatter for Nerrvana. What is Nerrvana? Nerrvana is a cloud service which allows you to run functional and cross-browser Selenium tests on demand. We hope it will help those who use the Selenium IDE to create and run tests or monitoring scripts in our cloud, and help you to transition from recording tests in the IDE to writing much more powerful and easy to maintain tests in Java. The Nerrvana formatter creates JUnit Selenium 1 tests. Today, we will set up the Selenium IDE, record and run tests, and showcase the possible future directions we may take this project. Let's begin by setting up the Selenium IDE. We assume you have it installed in Firefox. Go to the DeepShift Labs GitHub directory and load the Selenium IDE formatter for Nerrvana. Now I will connect to my Nerrvana account with Windows Secure Copy to use its File Explorer and upload the tests. The Nerrvana formatter sources you uploaded have two folders. The IDE formatter folder, where the Nerrvana IDE format is located, and the Space Template folder is a directory prepared to be loaded into Nerrvana. We will save our Selenium IDE tests in the Nerrvana format into the Space Template folder later on. We go to the IDE formatter directory. Open the formatter JavaScript file and copy its contents to the clipboard. Now we can launch the Selenium IDE from the menu or using Alt-Control-S. Go to Options in the main menu. If you have the latest version of the Selenium IDE, format can display this message. If this is the case, go to Options and tick Enable Experimental Features. Now the format menu is enabled and we can add the Nerrvana format. Click Add, give it a name, and paste the formatted JavaScript content we copied to the clipboard. Save it. Now we can check that a new format is available and select it. Now we will record a few tests using Nerrvana's login page as a lab rat. We record a correct login and logout test. Open the Nerrvana login page. Enter correct credentials. Click the button. Check the sign out text. Click sign out. Check the text, sign into Nerrvana. Then a test which attempts to log in with a blank login form. And a few more which logically follow: empty username, empty password, incorrect username, and incorrect password. When all of the tests are recorded, we will save them to the SRC folder in the Nerrvana format with the same name as the .java files. At the end, we will save the test suite as there are two ways to launch tests. It is important to name the test suite suite.java. We are ready to launch the tests in Nerrvana. Let's talk a little bit about the suite.java file. It contains all the tests in our suite, and we will be able to easily decide which tests we do not want to launch by commenting tests in it. The Java class name for an individual test should be the same as its file name. In the space template folder, we have the ant build file. By default, the all target will be used. However, there is a sweet target, and this is when the sweet.java file will be used. The rebuild and run shell script will be launching tests in Nerrvana. Remember, if no target is specified, all of the Java files will be launched. Or you can change this to the sweet target. We will keep the all target and show how to use the sweet target later in the presentation. Now you log into your Nerrvana account and create a new space. Open WinSCP and refresh the root directory to see the new space we have just created. Navigate to the directory named underscore files and upload the content from your space template directory here. Now we can create a test run. We select an executable file and select a few browsers. We will not validate tests because our tests use the Selenium driver available on the Nerrvana hub and the validation process will fail. We launch the tests and wait for them to complete. We can see that all the tests have been completed with no errors. The Nerrvana formatter uses messages that Nerrvana can read. So you can see the output of your tests in Nerrvana's user interface. Let's check what information is available. We go to the files out directory and open the ant log file. We can see all our tests here with zero errors. In the last line, test suite failed because we also had suite.java in the same folder. So it is a good idea to rename it to .java.something or delete it if you don't use it. You can see all 6 tests in 3 browsers completed in 149 seconds. Now we use the sweet target. Most of the FTPS clients support direct editing on a remote machine. I will comment all of the tests except one. And make a test we will launch to fail by changing the assert true parameter. We will create a new test run even though we could just edit and launch the one we created earlier. This time, we launch one test in one browser. Here, you can see an error our test caught. This time, since our test was modified to fail, we have a screenshot generated by tests created with the Nerrvana formatter. The log looks slightly different as we use the sweet target. Let's check the raw logs that Nerrvana makes. Here you can see a Nerrvana message which the test sent to the log. It was taken by Nerrvana, passed, and shown in the user interface. The format takes care of all of this. As you can see, it's quite easy to record tests in the Selenium IDE and run them in Nerrvana. You can see the Java code generated and can start modifying it and start making your own tests or modify them by gradually departing from IDE and moving into possibilities it cannot provide. Suddenly you realize new possibilities, such as programming tests to run in parallel. You can also use such tests to monitor your application. We will show you how to record these tests and run them in Nerrvana in our next video. If you are not a reader of our Selenium blog, we created our own Open Java framework. However, the reports our framework generates are more advanced. Here is an example report from our Answers application. You can see all of the individual tests on the left, and you can click them to get the hierarchical structure of all actions. With additional information, screenshots before and after each action, with various filters such as targets, duration, error message by level, and more. The report shown is for one platform only. Imagine how much time is needed to look through 6 or 7 reports your tests generated. We are extending our framework to be able to aggregate all reports into one and make them more convenient to use overall. Check the article, Reports, Our Take, in our blog for details. If there will be a demand from our clients, we will extend the framework to create reports in the same format for tests generated by the Nerrvana Selenium IDE formatter. Even though Selenium IDE tests have some limitations, it won't compromise the quality of the reports you see and will minimize the time you spend to analyze them. So please register your free account and give it a try. You can find the tests we generated during this presentation in our Selenium blog, just under the video. You will only need to provide your username and password in the login logout OK test. Please don't feel guilty if you run tests against Nerrvana's login page. This presentation is prepared by Deep Shift Labs, a team of web developers who have been working together since 2002 and created Nerrvana to satisfy their own testing needs. Thank you.